I don't own the rights to this music. I don't own the rights to this music. We do not own the rights to this music. Let's go. Hold on. Let me get my Facebook popping. No lo abandone. How y'all feeling tonight? What's up? You know I gotta get it lit. My husband be trying on his men's night, but we got this. What's the air on, babe? Hey, let's go, ladies' night. Where y'all calling in from? Where y'all chiming in from? Where y'all at? Let's go. Y'all know I gotta get it crunky crunk. Hey, let's go, ladies. What's up? Text some of your lady friends. Let's go. Hey. I don't own the rights to this music. Hey. We don't own the rights to this music. What's up, cuzzo? Hey, y'all see the title? Y'all see it? Do you show your husband gratitude, gratefulness, thankfulness? Hey, I see you cuzzo working out on the bike, on the classes. That's what I'm talking about. I fell off 2 days, but it's all good. I'm gonna get it back popping. Come on, let's go. Go to my Facebook. Not my Facebook. Don't own the rights to this music. But y'all know it's lit. It's Thursday. We're about to do the club one night. Go to our YouTube. Barker Family. Go to our YouTube. Tag some people. Like, share, subscribe. Let's go. Hey. I'm about to get in it. Ready? Y'all ready? Son la más fina, diga lo que diga. Hey, what y'all know about this? All right, let me go, because it's already 9:14. So good, though. Tag some of your peoples, some of your girls. We're about to get it. All right, so. It says it's foul. Okay. Because y'all know I hear the whole 18 minutes of this. So listen. Babe, what's the air on? You might have to lower it. You heard?
Yeah, you want some tea or something?
No, you might have to just lower it because it got me coughing. So, gratitude. You know, first and foremost, let's throw in the comments, what is one thing you're grateful for? And of course, the number one thing, because we're talking about the husbands tonight, we're going to say we're grateful for our husbands. But what else are you grateful for, ladies? What else? I know for me, I'm grateful for the understanding of patience. You know, I've been working on my patience, growing the patience, understanding it more. Why is this not working, babe? The internet. I'm going to look this up. And so what is one thing you guys are grateful for? Put it in the comments. And I'm grateful for, you know, God himself and giving us grace and mercy and guiding us and teaching us. No, man, because remember it messed up the other day. Babe, you turn the air off?
Yeah.
Okay, good, because it's messing me up.
Let me get your water.
Okay, thank you. See, it messes my thing up. Okay, there it goes. So, gratitude. The quality of being thankful, readiness to show appreciation for and to return kindness. Oh, where's my pen? You see my pen over here? Oh, right here. To return kindness. I didn't even think grateful had the returning of kindness, which makes sense because when we're grateful, we're returning, we're showing and we're giving back the love, the kindness, the generosity. I like that return. Y'all know I'm a note taker. The kindness. When you're grateful, because let's think about it. If you're grateful, you're going to... If you're grateful, you're going to return being kind. You're going to return the joyfulness, the happiness. You're going to give that back. You know, you appreciate this person so much. You're going to give back love, kindness, appreciation, things like that, right? So one of the questions that I have, so I got four questions I want us to walk through. And the number one question that came to mind was, are you truly, truly grateful for your spouse? Are you truly grateful for your husband? Wives, are you truly grateful for your husband? And it's not just, you're grateful for time with each other. Yes, that is, you know what? I love the time with each other. I love when we're spending time with our spouse. We're showing that gratitude. What's up? We got Mr. Webb in the building. We're showing that gratitude. We're showing that appreciation. We're showing that love. So when I ask the question, are you truly grateful for your significant other? Are you really? Or are you just now gotten to the comfortable stage? Or are you just now gotten to the part that you just go day to day? You're not even giving them things. You're not giving them appreciation. You're not giving them love. The number one thing when it comes to life is gratitude. Gratitude. And let me read to you. You guys know I'm reading the Happy Wives Club. I'm about to finish. I got three more days for the month and it's almost done. And one of the things, and this is how today's word came to me, it was saying, let me read to you this gratitude part. My happiness is a natural byproduct of that gratitude. My happiness is a natural byproduct of that gratitude. Gratitude is attitude. Y'all know the song. If you don't know the song, look it up, called Gratitude. It's so amazing. My mentor, Mr. and Mrs. Webb, shared that song with us, and it's been incredible. We put it on every day in our house, most of the days, especially with the kids. I'm grateful. I'm thankful. I'm grateful. It's so amazing. It says, gratitude unlocks the fulfillment of life. It turns what we have into enough and more. It turns denial into acceptance, chaos into order, confusion into clarity. It turns problems into gifts, failures into success. I'm going to pause right there. Ladies, especially for my wives on tonight, you know, even the husbands on, or soon to be husbands, right? I see some of y'all. What up? What up, War? Think about this. Failures into success. Ladies, wives, how many times do we say, he's not doing this, he's not doing that, can't believe this, he this, he not, nah. That's just straight fail. Like, that's just wah. If we turn that into gratitude, I'm thankful he's helping out in the house. I'm grateful he's going to his everyday job and providing. I'm grateful. Not only are we speaking life, but we're also doing affirmations to our spouse. And now that's bringing that fail, the negative, to the positive, into success. You know, and it's so good about this, because me, that now that I've been learning, I'm showing Brandon more gratitude. There's throughout the day, every, you know, I'm human. So I think before I say a lot of things now, before I used to just be like, oh, you're not doing this, or you didn't do this, you didn't. And he used to like, okay, whatever. But now it's the opposite. I'm like, man, I'm so grateful you picked up that clothes today. I'm so grateful you did that over there, man. And sometimes, for my ladies out there, sometimes he might not have done it still. But I throw it. And you know, some of y'all might call it being a little smart, being a little witty. But sometimes I do, like, man, I'm so thankful for you helping with them dishes the other day. And he knows he didn't. And he's like, babe, I'm thankful for you, dude. You know, thank you. You know? So sometimes, think, you know, I'm not saying be funny all the time, be dramatic and be extra, but it is very important on keeping the gratefulness. Thank you, Mr. Webb. I appreciate you. He's right here listening to Cobain with his Bluetooth. You know, we gotta, we're multitasking. I'm doing the wife's call tonight. He's listening into our amazing crypto educators. We gotta stay focused, stay educated. And, you know, just be grateful. I'm grateful he even wants to be in here and listen to more education when it comes to finances. You know, ladies, like, let's pay attention on what they're doing positive. Let's be grateful for what they are doing. And this is me, too, because I used to be like this. I used to be really intense, like, well, Brandon, you didn't do this and you didn't do that. I can't believe, like, it was a point that I was so petty, I would call him at work and be like, you seriously didn't do this today? Now, I'll just do it. And then I don't even say something sometimes, or sometimes I will be like, man, just did the dishes, you know, helping with the kids. And he knows inside, maybe he was supposed to been do that, right? He's like, man, babe, I'm sorry. I forgot. I didn't get to do it. I thank you. I appreciate you. And that's it. It's deaded. Back then, the old last year me, couple months me, would have been like, I'm not doing it. You do it. You know, you were supposed to do it. Why you didn't do this? You know, and all it brought was failure. Failure. This is so good. Failure to success. The unexpected into perfect timing and mistakes into important events. So good, so good. Gratitude makes sense of our past, brings peace for today, and creates vision for tomorrow. Ladies, even if you're not a happy wife right now, today, tonight, get this book. You know, I know it's a little messy, but this book has been through the rain, through the storm, through the sun, has been with me everywhere. I take this book everywhere because I'm reading it. Even if you're in between, or if you're like, Jen, I can't stand him, or Jen, we're thinking about the D word, or Jen, get this book. And I don't get paid for marketing. I should, because I've been going in on this book. But it's so incredible what this lady has done. And the fact that, for one, she's a minority. She's an African-American female going throughout the world, learning from other marriages that have been over 25 years married and happy. You know, the wives. And what is the secret? The number one secret in this book, and I'm going to tell y'all because y'all going to get it anyways, has been respect. Respect and gratitude. Every happily married person I interviewed on my trip was grateful for his or her spouse. Grateful. Gratitude. How much easier will life be if we just show our spouse, our husband, the gratefulness? Like, even think about this. Like, I've even done this with our kids, and I noticed the change. You know, Brandon was the one that helped me with this. He'd be like, babe, just, you know, say it this way or do it that way. Or tell them, man, I'm just so grateful for you. Which my kids know, but telling them on a daily, every 5-10 minute basis when they're really not doing that great. Man, I'm so grateful for you listening today. You know, you're doing so good. Man, I appreciate you guys listening and helping mommy in the house. And you'd be surprised how quick, especially my 4-year-old, he'd be like, mommy, are you happy? Are you grateful for me? Are you thankful for me? Do I gotta do this? Do I gotta do that? Mommy, oh, I fold so good. Like, he really does, though. For a 4-year-old, my 4-year-old folds clothes like nobody's business. Like, my mother taught him no games. And he's like, mommy, are you grateful for me? Are you grateful I did this? Are you happy? And it keeps the success going in our house. And I see the difference compared to, you're not listening. Why you don't pick up your clothes? Why you're not doing this? Why this? Why this? Why not? Want. Negative, negative, negative. And you guys know the husband says he doesn't want a nagging wife. And if we're that wife that we're always like, well, you didn't pick up the clothes, and you didn't help with the laundry, and you didn't do the dishes, and you, like, first of all, we talking to them like they're a child. This is our spouse. The respect and the level of gratitude should be a different type of business. We should talk to them, and this is talking to me too. Like, don't think this is just I'm perfect. No, you who know me know this has been taking time and effort for me as a person to grow with the patience and gratitude for Brandon. Because I realized that sometimes we take for granted what we have in our spouse, and we don't really see the gratitude in it. Sometimes we take for granted that you have a loving man in your home, that you have a loving father to your kids in your home, that you have a hardworking man that provides for your family, that you have a faithful, God-fearing man. Sometimes we forget these things because we're just going, and we're so quick to talk about the bad and you this and you that. And it's like, girl, how many ladies out there praying for a husband? I put that on my notes. How many ladies are out there praying for a husband? I know a couple of my friends praying for a good husband, not just a husband, a good God-fearing, loving man. They're praying. Like, there's women out there that are, you know, single, that are waiting for that husband to come. And we have it, and we're just, you don't do this, you this. You, and we're pointing the finger, and it's like, wait a minute. Like my mentor says, one finger you're pointing at them, you got these three pointing back at me. Maybe even four, depending on how you talk. So what are you doing? So one of my, our family counselor, our family therapist, we've been going to her for years. I remember she said, I think it was her, maybe it was a book, I'm not sure. One of our mentors mentioned, you want him to pick up his clothes all this time. How would it be if you just picked it up one day? And just avoid that whole argument and conflict of, you're not picking up his clothes, you're not picking up his clothes, you're not picking up his clothes. So one time I said, you know what? And I still do it sometimes. Like there's some socks or something on the side. He knows I'll sometimes pick it up and do my due diligence. But then there's other times, ladies in the building, I would be like, hey, babe, can we practice on cleaning the area a little bit? Like your side mainly. Can you pick this up? Like, let's see what we can do, right? So that was number one. Are you truly grateful for your spouse? Number two. Oh, and then the other thing, before we go into number two, this should be priority in marriage. We talked about priority yesterday in the marriage talk. Make sure you go listen in, review, replay, send it to people. I don't know. Just listen, share, like, everything. It was incredible about the 11 priorities every marriage, you know, should have. One of those absolutely was grateful. Gratitude. You know, this should be a priority. You know, it helps, like the book said, it goes from the failure to success. You know, you're doing affirmations, you're showing appreciation. I told people months ago, I told my wives months ago, 10 affirmations a day to your spouse. It should be, they say five, they say five saves a marriage. I say 10. And, you know, at first, me and Brandon were going back and forth, like, 7, 6, 8. And now we gotten so accustomed of showing and telling that gratitude that we probably surpass 10. On a daily basis, we probably surpass it. Especially right before bedtime, we're big on the prayer, the reading, the gratitude. I'm working on me because I'm usually trying to put something up on social media less, you know, and I know my mentor mentioned that today, like, falling asleep on the social media, not the best. You should fall asleep to some positiveness, some affirmation, some gratefulness. It's really good for your soul. It's really good for your mind and your heart, right? So then we go into number two. Some of y'all about to get hit over the head. Ladies. You already know. Do you pray for your husband? I'm going to let that one sit right there. Y'all see my shirt, Travel and Trade? You already know. Want some more trades today. Got some more dollars. Got the bag again. It's been a grateful day, grateful morning. Every morning I say it's going to be an amazing day in the charts, and it has been. I'm very grateful for the wisdom, the knowledge that I've been growing through our... You know, you have to, and this is a side note, when you want to learn and grow something, you should go to the sources that really have and can share this wisdom with you. You know, I'm not talking about YouTube or your friend next door that made six figures in a day. No, I'm talking about like legit education, study, understand, grow, and learn from qualified mentors and individuals. That's what we've been doing. We've been plugging in. You know, my husband's right here next to me. He's plugged in into our digital currency. And if you don't know, it's the main one is Bitcoin. But there's plenty. There's over 10,000 of them that you can always... And even though it's crashed, like they say, don't believe the news, guys. It's all hype. People making money today off of the Bitcoin going up and down, up and down, 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 up and down. You know, people making money today off Ethereum. People making money today off the currencies, the foreign exchange. You know, the dollar has been doing some crazy stuff and the currencies are showing it. And like myself, I'm making the money going down or up. It's daily. Like you don't have to wait. Oh, I got to wait for Bitcoin to come up to 100K. No, you don't. And if that's how you really feel, you know, contact me. Let's talk. Let's message each other. I want to help educate a lot of my peoples and make these millions that are out there because the money is out there. Believe it or not. Anyways, back to number two. Do you pray for your spouse? Do you literally pray? Like, do you ask him? Hey, babe, is there anything you need me to pray for you today? Anything you want me to, like, when I talk to God later? Is there anything you would like me to pray on your behalf? Or, and you know, realistically, hey, babe, can you pass me those cards? Open that drawer. The drawer. There's some little cards on the side. Some little cards. Yeah. So I have these, ladies. One of my friends, and this is why it's good to be connected with amazing women. One of my friends from a couple years back from our women's Bible group, she had recently went through a divorce and it was tough, but you know, she was going through it, still believes in God and has faith and knows one day her time, blah, blah, blah. She's amazing, right? She gave me these cards. And I'm pretty sure she might see this live tonight. If you do, hey girl, I love you and thank you. I still got them. They're amazing. And at first, she came one day. She was like, hey Jen, I don't really use these. These are prayer cards for your husband. So here you go. And I was like, you know, all right. At the time, I wasn't as deep into prayer, especially for my husband. I was like, honestly, I barely thought about that. I just said, you know, thank you for today. Thank you, God. Come help me. I need this, I need that. Like, you know, the regular old school hip brain. Until you really learn deep conversation with God. So when she gave me this, at first, like I said, I was like, okay. Now that I'm so heavy with it, there's days that I just like, literally, I go like this. Like a deck of cards. And I just go and pick like one or two. And I read it. So this one says, Lord, make me the kind of woman my husband can be proud to say his wife. And if you guys want to get these, I don't know where she got them, but I do know the author Stormy, the one that does the books, Power for Praying Wife, Power for Praying Husband, Praying Kids, all that. I believe this is her, and she, I guess she has these, right? This one is great. Breathe your life, O Lord, into our marriage. You know, so I just get some of these and I look at it. And then the other thing when it comes to praying for your husband, and of course you ask him, but even if you don't, like let's say if you forgot to ask him that morning. Oh man, I didn't get to ask him. He's at work, can't really talk to him. There's the book, The Powerful Praying Wife. It's incredible. And that book literally outlines so many subjects, so many chapters of what we can pray for our husbands. It goes deep. It goes finance, health, wealth, workday, temptations. What else? It's just a lot, right? So if you don't get into the praying part, like, oh, babe, what can I pray for you, blah, blah, blah. It's okay. Like, get you some of these. Or you know your spouse is working. Simply pray for his workday. You know, Lord, that you protect him, that you cover him, that he has a great day, that he has positive vibes, that he doesn't have no issues, and that he's going through, you know, the day as peaceful as can be. And depending on the career, you want to also get in detail. Like for me, Brandon is a lot with customers. He has a lot of customer clientele and experience. So I pray a lot that he's protected around those people, that temptation and that the devil does not sneak in through those people. Because you never know what customer can be on some evil stuff. Like, for real, for real. During COVID, when he went back to work, I prayed that he was covered and protected daily. And, you know, things like that. I pray every single morning when he's on the way to work. Like, ladies, wives, let's be more aware of praying for your spouse to drive, to get to work safe. Like, I don't care if he works on the block. Like, right on the block, at the corner. He's right there. You see him. Pray for that walk. Because that walk, anything can happen. Anything. So every morning I pray. It doesn't matter. Even when I have to be in the bed, knocked out. He give me a kiss. And I really quick, God protect him on the drive to work. Really quick. I don't think there's a day I ever did not. Like, to this day. Ask him about it. It shows appreciation for him. It shows you're affirming him. It shows that you're showing that love, that you care. And listen, words are powerful, right? Number three, do you show him you're grateful for him? Do you show him you're grateful for him? And I know some of us are like, Jen, I show him every day, or even if you're giving him some on the weekends or whatever you're doing, I'm talking about on a daily basis. Like, do you show him on a daily basis? What are your actions? What actions as a wife are you showing your husband that you're grateful? Right? What actions as a wife are you showing your husband that you're grateful? You know, do you make his breakfast? Do you make his lunch? These are behaviors and actions that the husband feels appreciated, and that's showing him gratitude. Like, I know some mornings, not every morning, but some mornings I do get up, and as I'm doing my meditation, before I do my meditation and stuff like that, I'll get up and I'll go do his salad. I don't have to. I could just be doing my own thing. He could make it. But I most days I try to do that. You know, what actions are you doing? Are there days that you're just like, oh, I'll take care of this today. Don't worry about it. You know, are there days that it might have been his laundry day, but you're like, you know what? Let me just throw that in there. It doesn't always have to be like perfectly aligned, guys. You can, you know, ladies, like, make things up. Like, start getting more engaged where he's like, man, thanks. Like, I was tired today from work and I didn't really want to tell you, but I appreciate it. You cleaned the kitchen, you know, you made dinner, you know, you helped with the laundry. And I know some wives are like, I already do all that, Jen, blah, blah, blah. That's great. What else can you do? There's never enough. That's the way I feel. It's not like, oh, I did the dishes at the kitchen, the laundry, the food. I did this. I'm done. He should be grateful. That's just having a bad attitude about it. Like, we're not doing that. That's not being appreciative, ladies. You know, come on. Like, what else can we do? You know, and to be honest, if you're doing all that, like, especially if you have, like, the Friday you clean or the Saturday we going in, blah, 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 end the night off with a popping sexy lingerie outfit to, like, cherry on top. Because guess what? Y'all know, wives, I get into this at every single time. You already know. Guess what? You did all this all day. What do you think he's going to do for you when you have that sexy lingerie? You're going to be the breakfast, lunch, dinner, entree, appetizer, all of it. You're going to be the whole meal. Like, think about it. And I know y'all husbands, if y'all on, you're probably like, oh, that's what she be doing. That's why I come home, dishes done, food done, everything did, and now she on the table, like, ready. Yeah, like, serve me. Like, I'm telling y'all, wives, take note. Take note, take the tip, take the advice. Try that. I promise you, you will probably get so much better serving in the bedroom with him being so grateful for you and appreciative that he's gonna want to go all out. Like, he's gonna be like, yo, I gotta put in work. Like, she done did dinner, dishes, laundry. She done got the sexiness going on. Oh, this me right here. And I'm putting y'all on game, wives, because Brandon has told me. He's told me this, like, wow. Like, you really my wife. Like, this is all me. Like, damn. Like, excuse my, you know, dag. I'm about to put in work. And I'll be like, yo, that's the whole plan. So, ladies, take note, man. Take note. What behaviors do you do? What words are you using for your spouse? Are you telling him? Are you really telling him that you're grateful? And listen, it's okay to just tell your husband, hey, babe, I'm grateful for you. Like, that's it. It's okay. You don't have to get all creative and, you know, the notes and this and that. Yeah, that's all romantic and sexy and cute. But you don't have to do all that all the time. Like, if you guys would listen to how much I tell Brandon how grateful I am for him every day, y'all would be like, yo, Jen, you're not tired of telling him? Like, I think he heard you. Like, I think he heard you, like, 10 times ago. I tell him 199 times. Like, he knows it. Especially when we're about to go to bed. Yo, don't play with me in my bedtime when it comes to me and Brandon. The night-night, don't play. I tell him, I kiss on him, I rub on him. I'm grateful, I'm thankful. I'm so happy you're my husband. I'm so glad, you know, God brought you to me. Like, we go in. Because at the end of the day, guys, at the end of the day, ladies, and I know we probably don't want to think to this extreme, But God forbid, that is the night God chose to grab his hand and doesn't get back up the next day. Like, let's talk some realness. We should treat every day with our spouse like it's our last. We should treat every day with our spouse. The whole thing about going to bed angry, I'm not talking to him, I'm not giving him none, I can't believe he didn't do this, I can't. Is that gonna matter when your husband is gone? Is it gonna matter that he didn't pick up the socks on the floor and you're not talking to him when he's in a casket? Let's just talk. Like, I have learned throughout the years that the small things, they matter, but they really don't. The gratefulness matters more. Pick up the sock, give him some love, say goodnight, pray together. And if he goes, your heart is good. Like, I'm straight. I done got some last night. I done picked up his sock. He done told me he was grateful. He loves me. I'm the best thing in his life. I'm the best wife he's ever had. Because, of course, as you affirm him and gratitude him, I'm pretty sure he's going to give it right back if your actions are aligned. So if it does, if he does, dude, we good. He told me I was the best wife he ever had. So he not here no more. Guess what? I'm good. Check, bucket list. I've been the best wife. And last but not least, do you teach your kids to be grateful for their father? Do you teach your kids to be grateful? Now, if you don't have kids, it's absolutely fine. But do you teach your family to be grateful for your spouse? Like, listen, there's times, y'all know I keep it gangster with y'all. There's times I remind my mother, my own mother, like I remind her, like, man, aren't you just grateful that I got such a great husband? Like, he provides, he's a great father, he's in our kids' lives, he's in my life, he's in your life. Like, he didn't have to be. You got, you ladies, wives, do we understand that our husbands does not have to be with us? The same way we don't have to be with them. I get that. But I'm just being realistic on the husband part. He doesn't have, like, if you have kids, he doesn't have to be involved. He could be like, okay, I made some kids, deuces. There's plenty of them out there. Remember, I'm a therapist. I deal with families left and right that their parents are not involved in their lives. Their own parents have told them, I want nothing to do with you, have a nice day, and leave. So do you teach your kids? Like, listen, I tell our 8-year-old all the time, man, you know, Francisco, some friends, some kids don't have daddy at home. Either he left, either he's in heaven or not, or wherever he passed away to. But we need to be grateful for daddy. We need to be grateful and thankful that he's here, that he's helping us, that I tell my kids, yo, be grateful he loves mommy, be grateful he's, you know, playing games with y'all. Like, you guys, I know wives are probably on here like, you're grateful for him to do that. He's supposed to. He's the father. He doesn't have to. There's a lot of deadbeat dads out there. No offense. Let's just, you know, I don't like the negative vibes, but let's just be real. There's a lot of them. There's even active, non-active dads. What do I mean? You're married, but the dad is not doing nothing with the kids. Like, absolutely, it's just the dad that goes to work, comes home, watches TV, plays video games, goes to bed, eats. He's just like a walking person in the home, but he's not actively engaging with our kids, your kids. There's different dads out there now. We could get talking about what dads do and don't do, what the roles are. So let's be grateful. The small things. I tell Brandon, yo, I'm grateful you was playing basketball with the boys last night. I mean, you know, yesterday. I wasn't going to do it. I'm grateful you was playing ball with them. I'm grateful you get excited to, you know, just come and sit and watch, you know, a Spanish movie because, you know, we're doing more Spanish in the house. I'm grateful that you sit with us. It's just, like, literally no lie. Like, everything. Everything. And you know, he shouldn't have to, but he does. Same with me. We just got to be realistic. Are we teaching our kids to be grateful for our husband? Man, you know, daddy goes to work hard all day. I tell my kids like the real deal. Like, is y'all think I'm real with y'all? I'm real with the kids. I'm real with everyone. You have to be authentic with our kids. You have to be authentic with our kids. Hey, Miss Amita in the building. Amazing, amazing Christian coach. Grateful for you, sis. I'm grateful for you, sis. You and Mr. Dwayne. Congratulations. Congratulations. Anniversary. I love y'all. You know, just show grateful gratitude. Tell, show your kid. Like, I keep it so real with my kids. I'm like, are y'all happy daddy goes to work and you know, he has money? And, you know, like, I speak a lot of things into existence. And I tell our kids, like, yo, daddy has millions. Like, are y'all excited? Like, we're wealthy. Like, we're rich. Like, I literally talk to my kids like that. And it's so funny because Francisco, he's like, mommy, can I tell my friends that we're rich? And I'm like, no, not yet. Don't let the secret out yet. You know, but it's just in the mind of showing them their gratitude for their dad, their excitement for their dad, the respect, the appreciation. You know, think about it. Like, simple, fixing the bike. I wasn't going to do that. Like, I'm really quick to call 1-800-BOB-THE-BUILDER, come help me do this. I'm not doing, like, that's just, you know what I'm saying? Like, no, I tell them, be grateful. Daddy did that. And I give all credit to him. Daddy did that, Francisco. Of course, you know, we give God credit to God first. But when it comes to, like, manual work, I'd be like, Francisco, daddy did that. He wanted some lights in his room. I'm like, mommy's not going to do that. I just keep it real with y'all. And, you know, ask your dad. Are we showing them the level of respect? And then another thing when it comes to gratitude with our kids and showing them the level of respect for our spouse, when it comes to discipline, do you understand, wives, that when we discipline our kids and we don't let our spouse discipline correctly, or they're not even disciplining because you're always jumping in and being in control, that's a form of disrespect in the eyes of the kids. So now they don't even value the dad. Now the gratitude is out the window. Like, why am I going to be grateful for daddy? Like, he don't even tell me what to do. He don't even this or he don't even that. Like, that's a big deal. I had to learn about this too, because when the boys were smaller, I would jump in a lot and be like, no, babe, like, don't do this, or, you know, try this. And, you know, I remember one time Brandon was like, listen, if you're not going to let me discipline our kids as well, I'm not going to get involved, and you handle them and let's see how that goes. And I was like, nah, we're not doing that. I want your word in this house too. You know, I want your wisdom, your authority to be spoken in this house. Because let's think about this, wives. If we're cutting that authority off from our spouses, now what? Who's the leader in the house? Who's the head? Like, it goes so deep. It goes to it's so intense that it goes to the part of even, like, I remember one time my 8-year-old said, he's like, mommy, I'm tired of asking daddy. And I was like, you gotta still ask daddy. He said, but you know, you said this. I said, I understand what I said, but we still gotta talk to daddy. We gotta see how he's thinking, what he's feeling, blah, 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 blah. So then one day he goes, mommy, why you can't do your own stuff? Why you can't say your own things? Why you can't just tell me? And, you know, he started getting into all these, why I can't say this, why can't. He's like, he's not the boss of you. You're the boss. And I said, listen, mommy's the boss, daddy's the boss, we're bosses. Yes. And I had to explain it. Like, we're married, and mommy talks to daddy. Daddy talks to mommy. And at the end of the day, it's God, and then daddy, and then mommy. So mommy is going to go talk to daddy. And if daddy says cool, then we cool. But if I say yes and he says no, we got to roll. Daddy's not feeling it. Ugh. Daddy always this. I don't want to ask daddy. And I said, well, let's talk to daddy about it. Let's see. Like, some stuff I talked to him, like, let's see how daddy really feels about this. And I'll talk to Brandon sometimes, like, hey, babe, you were kind of hard. And of course, wives, we're doing this separate too. We're not disciplining our own spouse in front of our kid. Like, they go to bed, or another day, another time, we go to the back, whatever. And we talk to our spouse. And I tell Brandon, like, daddy, babe, that was kind of hard. It's like, I thought this was cool, but you said no. Like, you know, and then sometimes he does come back and be like, you know what, Francisco, I talked to mommy. Yeah, we're going to do this. So he also does edify me and give me also that appreciation and gratitude and level of authority and says to the boys, yes, daddy said no, but we talked to mommy. And you know what? Okay, cool. Let's roll with this. Showing that respect level to your kids on the attitude with the spouse, with, you know, with their dad, it's a big deal. Showing the gratefulness. Big deal. You know, going to all the kids' events. Like, I've had some of my some events, my son tells me, mommy, like, I never see, like, where's so-and-so's dad or where's so-and-so's mom? And I'm just like, I don't know. We just got to be grateful for us being here. We got to be grateful daddy can come to the games. We got to be grateful he does everything he can in his power to be at these events, to come to these games, to be the coach, to be volunteering. Grateful, grateful, grateful. Gratefulness brings abundance of happiness, brings abundance of just love. It just shows appreciation. We show God how much we appreciate certain things and certain people. It's just going to be more and more and more abundant, more and more growth. It's a big deal. Like, I'm heavy on showing Brandon appreciation and gratitude. I'm big on it. Like, I don't play. Even if I'm mad at him, I'm still like, babe. And y'all gonna think it's funny, ladies, but sometimes I be mad, but I'm just like, I'm just so grateful you so fine. I'm just so grateful you sexy. You get on my nerves, but I'm just so grateful you give me some good loving. And he be so mad. He's like, are you serious? That's what you're gonna say? And I'm like, I'm not feeling you right now, but I know you got some good qualities. When you know what I'm saying, when we handling business, so at least I'm gonna tell you some form of gratitude. And he'd be like, really? He'd be like, really, babe? I'm like, yeah, absolutely, absolutely. So yeah, guys. So, you know, make it fun. Show your spouse that love. All I'm gonna say to my ladies out there is, at the end of the day, tomorrow's not promised. I'm heavy on that. Like, I'm real big on tomorrow's not promised. I cherish, like my cousin said, she's grateful for her time with her husband when they can do it. I cherish every moment possible I can with my husband. And even when we're angry or if I'm upset with him, I get over it fast. Like, literally within, like, minutes or a couple hours. Like, okay, I'm over it. Like, give me some kisses. I love you. I'm grateful. Because I've seen spouses lose their spouse. I've seen stories. I've heard stories. My mother lost my dad when I was 9. I see what she went through. I still see what she goes through to this day. So tomorrow's not promised. You know, ladies, show the gratitude. Try it. Like, do your own challenge. Do a challenge, like a week of no negativeness. Try a week. If you can't do a week, try a day or two. Now, and then the last thing I'm going to say, and then I'm going to end it. The last thing I'm going to say is, sometimes, wives, it might not be our husbands. What if it's us? We're so busy on being upset that he didn't pick up the socks or pick up the pants or do this or do that. What if it's me? What if I'm the one tripping? What if I'm the one just, you know, having an attitude? When it's like, Jen, he eventually, like, Brandon, like, babe, I'm about to pick it up. Like, relax. You know? Sometimes it's us. We got to realize that. We got to take responsibility and say, sometimes it's us. So, ladies, for the week, let's see how y'all do. Let's see if y'all could do this for the whole week. Try it. A day, 5 days, 3 days, something. Try the gratitude over the bad attitude. Like, try it. Like, don't say for a week. Like, and you know what? I'm going to say something else. Do it without him even knowing. Like, don't even be like, oh, babe, I'm about to do a challenge about being nice to you. Don't do it. Especially if you're that wife that always complains to him and nags. That used to be me. Especially if you're that wife, don't even say nothing. Just start doing the opposite. Remember, failure turns into success. So instead of being frustrated that, oh, he didn't pick up the kids today. I got to go get him. Don't even say nothing. Just be like, you know what, babe? I got it. Sometimes we don't want to do stuff, but we got to do it. You know, and then I think a lot about, like, the Bible. Like, sometimes Jesus didn't, what if he didn't want to die on the cross? Man, I don't feel like dying on the cross today. You know what? I'm not going to do it for these people. But he did it. He still did it. Like, his mission was to die on the cross for us, for our sins. Our mission is to be a good wife. Our mission is to be a helper. You know, our mission is to be that grateful, wonderful partner to your spouse. So try it. Try it, ladies, like a whole week or at least a few days. No negatives. You didn't get this. You haven't done this. Why you can't do this? No, cut that out. Do the opposite. If he hasn't done the dishes in the 3 days, do the opposite. You know, I'm just so grateful I'm doing these dishes today. Woo! Thank you, Jesus. I'm so glad you are still in this house. You know what? We're still together. Isn't that great? Switch it up. And maybe because of your good attitude, he might be like, I'm about to do other stuff. I'm about to do other things around the house. I'm about to show her my surprise. And if he doesn't, it's absolutely okay. Because we know we're doing good for our marriage, for ourselves, and for our spouse, which is what God wants us to do. So keep it going. Eventually, you're going to be blessed. Like, listen, I don't wash dishes several nights in a row. And I'm like, I don't wash these dishes 3 days in a row now. You know, and there was a time, sometimes I still do, was so petty. I have an app, right? There's this app I told y'all ladies about it called Cozy. My friend April told me about this app called Cozy. I download it. He downloads it. We put stuff and we both see it. Like appointments, kids, blah, blah, blah. It was so real. I put the dates I was doing certain things around this house. It was that real, ladies. I would put, like, for example, let's say today, Thursday, I would put dishes Jen. Like, that's how real it got. Like, for real, for real. That's how petty it got. Because I will do dishes, and Brandon sometimes be like, you didn't do it. And I'm like, yes, I did. I did it 2 days ago. No, you didn't. I did. I'm like, no, I did. And we really would argue. Come on, ladies. Come on, wives. Don't play like y'all don't argue about no dishes or laundry. That's the two main things. Come on now. Stop it. And we literally go back and forth. Like, no, I did it. No, you did it. No, who? You don't remember? I did this. So, boom. I was like, solution. On the app, Jen dishes. It's right here. 3 days in a row, Jen dishes. Jen dinner. Jen dinner. It got that real. This was when I was learning growth, learning the pettiness. I thought it was cool. I thought it was the way. Now, I'm proud of me to say that I don't even do that. Now I'm just like, I don't even care. Dishes, whatever, I'll do it. It's been 3 days, 5 days. I don't even count, but whatever. But now he comes to me and be like, babe, I seen you wash dishes a couple of days. Like, I got it. Don't worry. Da-da-da-da. Now, sometimes I wonder, like, why we don't just use a dishwasher and just avoid all type of conflicts? I don't even know why. Sometimes we do, but sometimes it's just like, whatever, let me just do that. And, you know, to be honest, I even, to get it off my mind, we have the refrigerator, the smart fridge, that he got from his job. And so it has YouTube videos, all that stuff. So now I tried it the other day and it was actually pretty cool. I put on like meditation on YouTube and I'm doing the dishes, or I'll put like a praise and worship song and do my dishes. Or I even put like a first God prayer thing and I do the dishes, and it's just like, it don't even faze me. Like, I just be like, I just did it, babe. Sometimes he'd be like, I'm about to do this. She'd be like, no, I already got it. Don't worry. But then he comes through on other things. And it doesn't only have to be sex, though. But it can be. I don't have a problem with that. It can be both. Why not? Boom. Add the little cherry on top, right? You know, but other things flourish. Other things grow into abundance because of this. So listen, thank you all, ladies, for chiming in. Thank you for my wives on. Share this video. Go to our YouTube if you like, Barker Family. Share, like, subscribe. And you know, I said this last time, I really am big on sharing these videos because we never know. One of your friends that doesn't know me, that I don't follow, or that follows, that doesn't follow me, might need to hear this. You might have a girlfriend that you don't even know is battling getting along with her spouse and doesn't feel like showing him love. Like, no type of gratitude. Nothing. Like, they're not in a good space. Why am I going to show him love and appreciation? Because failure into success. That's what gratitude does. It builds the abundance in your heart. You know, so share the videos. Like let's share the love. Like, honestly, Brandon and I were talking about this the other night. Our mission is to be, you know, impacting multiple millions of families. Like, we want to be in households all around the globe where if you're going through a struggle, tap in. And I'm not perfect. We're not perfect. We go through things too. You know, but I keep it real. We've been through some things. We're talking about it. I have my degree in therapy. He's an amazing, you know, situation that has been doing better. God's been working on him a lot. And it's, you know, we're here. We're here for people. So you never know, guys. Share, share, share. Have fun. Marriage is fun. Marriage doesn't have to be boring. You can spice things up. If it's been 100,000 years and you're just like, it's not going to work out, it's just boring. No, it's not. You're making it boring. You gotta. If it's boring to you, you make it happy. You make it fun. Show the love. Show the appreciation. Check out these cards. I appreciate y'all. Thank y'all for chiming in. I'm going to go ahead and pray this out really quick. Father God, thank you for tonight. Thank you for tonight's word. Thank you for, you know, bringing me wisdom and, you know, everybody that was able to log on. Thank you for all the lives that are going to be impacted. Thank you for, you know, everyone being able to share this amazing, amazing review and going over different gratitudes for our spouse, that you're able to bless these marriages, that you're able to help some of these, you know, wives that are struggling with showing the gratitude, that you're able to help me to continue to show Brandon gratitude and the love I have for him. Thank you for just everything you do, that you continue to impact us, to grow our lives, to show through the Holy Spirit everything that you want for us, and that we have a rest of a beautiful, blessed night and a blessed of the week. You have, in Jesus' name I pray, amen, amen, amen. Thank you, thank you, thank you. All right, ladies, y'all have a blessed one. Stay safe. I see y'all next Thursday. I might be out of town or I might be home. I'm not sure, but I'm going to be on. We got to figure out a topic. This one was given to me literally like an hour ago. I was taking notes, thinking about what to read about, what to discuss, and it came up with the book. And I was like, man, this is perfect. Gratitude. Gratitude, gratitude. Y'all have a blessed one. Stay safe. Thank y'all.